Welcome to China Night 2021.
欢迎大家.
欢迎大家.
I'm Eric Yu, this year's High School South Chinese Club President.
I'm Jun Xiao, this year's High School South Chinese Club Vice President.
And I'm Jeremy Hui, this year's High School North China Night Coordinator.
We're so glad you're able to join us tonight for our annual celebration of Chinese culture. Historically, China Night has been a vibrant in-person Chinese New Year event, hosting over 600 members of the WWP community. From thundering lion dances to show-stopping modern choreography, our event showcases the incredible talent of our club members.
This year, to keep the community safe, China Night has moved to a virtual setting. Although there may not be boba stands or authentic food offerings, we have brought the essence of China Night for you to enjoy in the safety of your home.
In fact, this year's virtual setting has allowed us to bring the show beyond our immediate community and can be accessed from anywhere. So please, sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. Let's welcome up our MCs for tonight.
Hello everyone, welcome to China Night 2021.
大家好,欢迎来到今年的China Night. My name is Kevin.
My name is Laura. My name is Gracelyn.
And my name is Shiloh. We'll be your host tonight.
Hey Shiloh, Happy New Year.
New Year? I thought that was January 1st.
You meant Happy Chinese New Year. 新年快乐. In America, we follow the Gregorian calendar, which begins on January 1st. But in China, we follow the lunar calendar, based on the movement of the moon, or really, yeah. So actually, the Lunar New Year began on February 12th this year.
But it's May, not February.
Really? I thought it's February. I guess that explains the abnormally warm weather. Oh, dang, quarantine has really messed up my sense of time.
Okay, that doesn't matter. The real question is, what year is it?
It's the year of the ox. Chinese people believe that those born in certain years take on the characteristics of their zodiac animals.
I didn't really think that, but I guess that works too. And wait, by ox you mean like those things you plug into cards, like play some beats, right? That's whack. Why are you naming your cult?
No, you dumb dumb. That's an ox cord. We're talking about an ox.
Oh, you're like talking about like the orange wolf thing.
No, that's a fox. I'm talking about ox.
Oh, ox. Wait, why did you just say that in the beginning?
I did.
Yeah, sorry.
Now, before we begin, we would like to take a moment of your time to recognize our Chinese teachers. As without their help, none of this would have happened. So, everyone, please give a hand to the Chinese teachers. Anyway, I think we said enough. Let's get the show on the road. Without further ado,
sit back, relax,
and enjoy the show.
Woo! The first performance we have for you tonight is the traditional Chinese lion dance, or wusi. It is a custom dance performed by two dancers.
This dance mimics a lion's movements, hence the name lion dance. Some versions of lion dance incorporate martial arts into it. This version of the lion dance originates in the Guangdong province and is known as the Southern Lion Dance.
The story is that the lion dance originated from ancient China when an evil spirit called Yin came out on the last day of the year. It terrorized villagers and ate everything up, Trojan included.
Wow, the kids better be on their best behavior during the show tonight then.
Right. Anyways, this continued until one day, the villagers lit firecrackers and dressed as a fearsome lion, scaring the big bad monster away. From then on, every year, they did the same thing, and Yen never came back again.
What an interesting story. But it could also have just originated as an adaptation of Buddhist traditions and symbolism during the Tang Dynasty.
You know, fun.
Well, the lion dance is set to bring good luck and fortune for the new year. We ask you to give a round of applause and welcome our powerful alliance led by Eric Yu and Raymond Chung.
Flying our lion dance members. Thank you.
Wow, how great was that?
Yeah, just by watching that, I can feel my luck unfortunately increasing already.
Hey, do you think that will maybe get me lucky enough to get into Harvard?
Perhaps. Maybe perform that dance in front of the admissions officers and see what they think.
Anyways, up next, we're going to shake it up with some more pop and lively dancing.
The next dance will be to a medley of three songs, Love Cycle by Youth With You, Take Off by Wavy, and finally Yes Okay by Youth With You. So please welcome to the stage
the North Modern Dance Groove.
And hey, you know, speaking of singing, I've been told my voice suits perfectly for Tonghua by Michael Wong.
Oh really? How so?
Alright, let me show you.
我愿飞在童话里，你爱的那个天使，张开双手，愿这翅膀守护你。你要相信。Okay, okay, I think that's enough. Let's save performance for the real singers.
I guess, but I like to see the pop.
Moving on, the first one will be 想见你 by Hua Sanyo, which will be sung by Tanya Tian, Betty Liu, and Wen Yiguo.
Then, our ears will be blessed by the wonderful singing of Melinda Chen in their rendition of Yunian, written by Xiao Zan.
Without further ado, let's welcome our talented singers onto the stage.
Shiji, 才是刻骨铭心。 若能回到冰河时期，多想把你抱进处理，你的笑多疗愈，让人生也苏醒。失去你的风景像座废墟，像失落文明，能否一场奇迹一线生机，能不能又再一次相遇。想见你，只想见你，未来过去，我只想见你。穿越了千个万个时间线里，人海里相依。用尽了逻辑心机，推理爱情最难解的谜。会不会你也和我一样，在等待一句我愿意？任时光更迭了四季，任宇宙物换或心意，
愿不退流行是青涩的真心。
未来先进科技无法模拟你拥抱暖意。
想见你每个朝夕，想见你每个表情，想穿越每个平行的未来和过去紧紧相依。想 follow 每次爱意，不错过你的注意，不辜负你也一样等待着那一句我愿意。
想见你，只想见你，未来过去我只想见你。穿越了千个万个时间线里，人海里相依。用尽了逻辑心机，推理爱情最难解的谜。会不会你也和我一样，在等待一句我愿意。想见你，想见你，想见你，想见你，想见你，想见你，只想见你，未来过去我只想见你。穿越了千个万个时间线里，人海里相依。用尽了逻辑心机，推理爱情最难解的谜。
为什么你不在？问是否你会回来？夏天的风我永远记得，清清楚楚地说你爱我。我看见你苦苦的笑容，也有腼腆的时候。夏天的风总暖暖吹过，穿过头发，穿过耳朵。你和我的夏天风紧紧锁着。七月的风懒懒的，恋人都变热热的。不久后天闷闷的，一见云后雨下过。深到无法再忍受，索性闭上了双眼，让想象任意改变。场景两个人一起散散步，我的脸也轻轻贴着你胸口，听到心跳在呼唤，曾经一样温度。夏天的风永远记得，清清楚楚地说你爱我。我看见你苦苦的笑容，也有腼腆的时候。夏天的风钻暖暖吹过，穿过头发，穿过耳朵。你和我的夏天风紧紧锁着。 到高高的山峰，弯的风，山的风，吹成了山峰。温柔懒懒的海风，吹到高高的山峰，弯的风，山的风，吹成了山峰。温柔懒懒的海风，吹到高高的山峰，弯的风，山的风，吹成了山峰。为什么你不在？问身份你会回来？场景两个人一起散散步，我的脸也轻轻贴着你胸脯，听到心跳在乎我和天气一样温度。夏天的风我永远记得，清清楚楚地说你爱我，我看见你苦苦的笑容。
Wow, that was fantastic.
Yeah, that performance was solid, especially when compared to the way my mom sings it in the shower.
Well, I think it's time that we piao piao away from that last performance and move on to the High School North's super talented Zachary Lee and his skillful performance of the Chinese yo-yo.
The Chinese yo-yo, also known as tuling by Chinese speakers, is a Chinese toy that originated in the 1500s during the Ming Dynasty. Through large amounts of forced trade that occurred during the open door policy, it was brought to and popularized in the West during the 1800s, where Belgian engineer Gustave Viparte claimed that it was his invention, calling it the Diablo, or the Devil.
All right, less nerd talk, more action. Ladies and gentlemen, please give up your hands for Zachary Lee.
form is just breathtaking. I didn't know there's such thing as a Chinese yo-yo, but dang, it looks so cool. I want one now.
Same, same. Hey, you know what, Shiloh? I think it's time for some comedic relief.
All right, if you mean I should start singing, you got it.
No, I'm good. Why don't we start having some fun with some riddles and tongue twisters? People watching, you can all follow along and try to answer these questions and try the tongue twisters too.
Okay, I guess, well, let's get to it then.
Well, all right, Shiloh. I bet you can't say this once without messing up.
I got this. Easy, easy, it's easy. Okay, wait, one more time. Okay, no, whatever. Okay, that doesn't matter, but what matters is, okay, what does it mean in English?
Oh, I know. It's basically a tongue twister about eating grapes without eating the grape skin. It's kind of weird.
Okay, interesting. Well, okay, forget about the tongue twisters. You beat me, I can't do tongue twisters. But I bet you can't answer these questions. First question. The United States has been one unified country since 1776, hopefully you guys know, or roughly 250 years. And 250 years is what percent of the years in Chinese history?
21?
2? I think 7.
Correct. You definitely cheated, but yes, it is 7%. Okay, next question. In what country did India originate?
Oh, India, obviously.
Yeah, India?
No, Grayson's right, it's China. Okay, I know it's... Sounds weird, but yes, it did come from China.
Cultural appropriation.
All right, and next question. Why was the ox the year that we're in right now not the first in the zodiac race? The race to determine the zodiac.
Oh, I know this one. Because the stupid rat rode on the back of the ox and jumped toward the last minute.
Dang, I feel bad for the ox. You really got bamboozled.
Now, okay, second to the last question. Is Songhai a city or a province?
It's a city, of course. Pitbull literally raps about it in like 90% of his songs.
Okay? No, it's a province because it's so big. Nope, it's both.
Yeah, she is correct. It is not a city or a province. It's both. And finally, last question. Can anyone tell me what the next act is?
I don't know. What is it? Oh, I know. It's the skit.
Yup.
This year's skit is about the Jade Rabbit.
Jade Rabbit? You mean White Rabbit, right?
No, that's the candy.
Oh, so this is about where white rabbit candy comes from. I'm assuming it comes from the Jade Rabbit, right?
Not really. Just sit back, relax, enjoy the show, and find out for yourself.
All right.
Please welcome Alec Misha and his actors to the stage and give them a warm round of applause.
你好，你是否曾经想过，为什么月亮上会出现兔子形状的阴影？而这种现象可以用很久很久之前的中国民间传说来解释。很多人都知道嫦娥奔月的故事，但它那毛茸茸的伙伴又是从哪里来的呢？这便是玉兔的故事。很久以前，有一名名叫吴刚的神药制造商，他负责制作不朽药。凡人要想要不死的话，就必须每1000年吃一粒不朽药。然而有一次，吴刚向人类分发了太多药丸，激怒了玉帝。
你们这样子做啊，我玉帝对你很生气啊！我每次就是教你做事，你就是做错啊！其实哪里有人叫你这样子做啊？算了，现在你的惩罚就是把月亮上的桂花树砍下来，可以吧？啊，你可以没？可以不可以？
但是吴刚不知道的是，那棵树是一棵不死之树，它会一直长大，而且它将永远受到惩罚。
谁将成为下一个神药神呢？人类太容易腐败了。哦，我知道，我让一个动物成为下一个神药神。理解。在森林里面能找到合适的动物吗？
玉帝下凡，以寻找一只动物作为吴刚的接班人。他乔装成一个无家可归的人，企图遇见一些动物。
森林里的动物帮助玉帝一下，我玉帝迷路了，3天没吃饭，没喝水，请给我一些食物，所以我可以继续我的路程。
三只动物在附近听到了玉帝的叫喊声，它们分别是狐狸、猴子还有兔子，于是它们连忙赶回森林去寻找食物。 狐狸是第一个回来的。
你好，我是狐狸，森林里的小花店不带木梳回来了。
谢谢狐狸，你是一个能干的猎人，也是一个值得的灵魂，非常感谢你的帮助。
接着猴子回来了。
我是猴子，树梢的主人，我从说说中获得了新鲜水果。
谢谢猴子，你的能力给我留下了深刻的印象，你很顺练，竹地特别感谢你的帮助。
最后兔子回来了，但当他回来的时候，他的脸上露出了悲伤的表情。
我在整个森林中四处搜寻，但我只吃草，所以找不到任何食物供你食用。我无法帮助您完成任务，我会为您提供自己，以便您有足够的力量来完成自己的旅程。
就这样，兔子跳进了火里。
兔子不要。
玉帝对兔子的牺牲感动至极，以至于他决定将兔子带回天界。玉皇大帝找了下一位神药制造商，他把兔子的皮毛变得像白玉一样雪白，这也是玉兔名字的由来。随着时间的流逝，玉兔终于学会了制作不朽药的办法。为了保护玉兔免受凡人的伤害，玉帝将玉兔送到月亮上与嫦娥一起生活，直到今天他们都住在月宫。据说如果抬头仰望月亮，就会看到玉兔用杆敲打的身影。玉兔是无私、虔诚、牺牲的象征，每当人们抬头仰望月亮时，总会为玉兔争取正义的道德模范感到钦佩。
That was amazing. They put so much hard work into that and it really paid off.
I know, that deserves an Oscar. That deserves an Oscar. Up next, we have a traditional dance. There are many different forms of traditional dance. The dragon dance and the lion dance are two notable examples, but there are still so many other dances with their own respective styles and cultural significances.
For example, folk dances, ones that are done for rituals, and ones that are presented to the royal family at the Huanggong when there was still one. Traditional dances have a lot of history and can go back to around the Song Dynasty.
Up next, we have a group that is going to show us just one more of the many traditional dances performed in China. Please welcome Sydney Yam, Harry Kamishki, and Amber Min with their group showing us their traditional dance or Chuan Hong Wu Dao.
谁把思念轻描淡写，只想留足时间为你穿越。我听不白墙青瓦的屋檐，等你撑伞走过我身边，古镇上谁家笛吹雁，再为我们酝酿当年的月月。
一双鸳鸯栖在雨中打水面，就像思念苦里头捉念，我不问弱水三千，几人能为我愿，轮回百转只求陪你续前缘。一曲琵琶弦断弦
Alright, up next we have string quartet.
Oh, I get it. Quartet, like five.
No. How are you graduating? Okay, anyways, a quartet is made up of four string instruments. Okay?
Okay, well, I bet you one half of a bobo pearl that most of the students are interested to have at least played one string instrument at some point in their lives.
You're probably right. You know, I play the cello in fourth grade. I wanted to be the next yo-yo ma, but I never quite figured out how to tune my cello. And eventually broke it. So that was the end of that.
Alrighty then.
Well, let's invite our string quartet up to the stage, led by act leader Irene Cao. Be ready to enjoy some beautiful music.
Thank you.
Wow, that was music to my ears. I wish I was that good at playing string instruments. I can't even seem to play Wonderwall on my guitar.
Moving on, now be prepared to be transported back to ancient China with the beautiful, graceful, and charming music of traditional Chinese instruments.
Hey, Gracelyn, what will they be playing?
Great question, Kevin. They'll play the guzheng. The melodic sound is produced when the plucked strings vibrate in the sound box, creating a calming sensation. We hope you relax to the soothing sounds played on these exquisite instruments.
Please welcome Tanya Tan and Bessie Liu.
Wow, that was an amazing performance. I didn't know what traditional Chinese instruments even sounded like.
Me neither. Now, on to the next
fact. Wait, hold on. I think it's time. I forgot. Here, have this gift.
But it's not my birthday.
Yeah, but we are Chinese New Year in May.
So...
What do you mean, so? During Chinese New Year, you always give or receive red envelopes, aka hongbao, from others.
But what do you even put in these envelopes? Not dumplings or boba, right?
Yeah, totally.
Of course not. Usually there's money inside the envelopes. Money, give me. I love money.
I got you. Here. What is this?
Money, of course.
But it's red, not green. It's Chinese money, or renminbi. What, do you really think I'll give you American dollars? Heck no. Fair, well, I mean, well, I have something to give you all, I guess, then.
Really?
What is it?
This is a really special gift. The gift of watching South Modern Dance perform. Woohoo!
Thank you.
Wow, that was so much better than those TikTok dances. Next up, we have a short tale brought to you by one of Miss Yu's Chinese classes. We all know that the past year has been tough, but this play helps remind ourselves that there's always a light at the end of the tunnel. So without further ado, we present to you, Qian Li Zi Xing Shi Yi Zu Xia, a story of which the path to one's goal is not always easy. Let's welcome Miss Yu's Chinese for Honors class.
每个人的生活中，我们都会遇到挑战。有的人感到难过，因为他们觉得问题就没有答案；有的人感到生气，因为他们没事没刻，斗争可是没有用。有一天，一个学生叫宜昌说：“天哪，我的生活有太多的挑战了，连帮助自己成功都没有办法。我的梦想是当五星级的大厨。” 看来我想成为大厨的这个梦想永远都不会实现了。你同意吗?
一强,千万不要放弃你的梦想,你知道吗? 我妈妈总跟我说,如果生命当中遇到了困难,不能解决的话,我们可以找神仙帮忙。据说有一个人住在山上千年了,他可以帮你解决你的问题。
他的名字叫上帝。哦，我不明白你在说什么。上帝，上帝是住在山上的神仙吗？ 他到底住在哪一座山啊？
对，是上帝。你一定觉得我疯了，哈哈哈。他住在传说中的老山顶上。
你若是愿意付出时间上山去找他，他会许你一个愿望，什么都行。这不是我说的哦，是传说故事说的哦。如果我想有开心快乐的过生活，我一定要去哪一座山，找到他。好，只有这么办吧。我不能再浪费时间了，我先走了。 谢谢你告诉我。任何事情都拦不住我去见哪一位山顶上的上帝。给我站住！臭小子，你再这么下去！ 我就不客气了，先回答我的问题，回答对的话我让你过，回答不对的话今天你就是我的晚餐啦，听到没？ 他用生命保卫家园， 主人出门半路相随，好人见之自觉离开，坏人见之其言不顺。走开，别拦我，我已经浪费了我很多时间了。要是你不回答我的问题，我就把你的头砍了。别碰我，你这个妖怪。 再让我想一想。哦，是不是一把锁？答对了，就像这个，我丢给你，看看你会不会被压死。哈哈哈哈哈！啊！奇怪，我从来没见过恶魔。 我竟然跟恶魔说话，我在哪儿？我迷失方向，我迷路了。魏叔叔你好，
你在跟我说话吗？对，我想请问一下，你知道崂山怎么走吗？我当然知道啊，我告诉你吧，到崂山还有一段距离。 你想自己走到崂山可不是一件简单的事啊。
在途中你会面临各种各样的困难和挑战，你不可能成功的，不过我还是想帮你，但是我没有东西给你。
不管有多难，我一定会成功的，你看着吧，任何事情都拦不住我。我非常感谢你的帮助，我能为你做什么？
不需要，不需要，你不用为我做任何事。其实我也没做什么，但是我还是要告诉你，你不会成功，你这么傻，不可能成功的。
你胡说，你别小看我。这个我送给你，这是我自己做的，很好吃哦。我的梦想就是成为世界上最有名的大厨。
你疯了吧，傻孩子。但是真的很好吃。
再见。我在哪儿呀？这个罗盘一点用都没有。你好，你认识山地吗？
我就是山地，傻孩子。
哇塞，我终于找到你了。您好，山地，你真的看起来很年轻啊。你像青少年一样那么年轻。
哈哈哈，谢谢你的夸奖。你是？
我的名字叫以强，我有一个问题想要问你。
小伙子，我已经活了3000多年了，不，5000多年了吧。我已经没可用的魔法了，我不能许你一个愿望。
天哪，你的意思是，为了实现我的梦想，为了找到你，我败坏了我的时间？
不不不，你不用担心，你看看你翻山越岭这么努力的来找到我，你很有毅力。为了找到我，你克服万难，也付出了这么多的心力。凭着你的毅力和努力，你将来肯定会成为一个5颗星的米其林大厨。即使在你实现梦想的道路上，你肯定会遇到失败、挫折和伤痛，但是别让这些小事情阻挡你，让你飞。
哇，谢谢你的鼓励。听了你的一番话以后，我很受启发。我不能放弃我自己，我会加油。我现在想回家了。
我其实没有这个超级能力能够帮任何人成功的，这是天助自助者也。一强是靠自己坚韧不拔的性格成功的，他一定会有一个很好的未来。千百年来，我学到每个人都需要被鼓励的，因此面对困难时不怕挑战，还可以继续努力向前冲。我真心的相信一强将来会做得很棒。
山地的话灵验了。一强回到家以后，每天开始认真上烹饪课，学做饭。通过行动训练以后，他终于成为了世界上最好的厨师之一。
Wasn't that amazing? Up next, we'll watch one of the oldest traditions of Chinese culture, Kung Fu.
Developed over thousands of years, Chinese Kung Fu has evolved in complexity from hundreds of different styles. Today, its performance is absolutely amazing.
Did you know that Kung Fu actually emphasizes peace and non-aggression? Kung Fu originated from the principles of self-defense, despite its fighting styles. The ancient Chinese people lived in hostile surroundings, so they needed to practice Kung Fu to protect themselves.
Mastering Kung Fu requires practice, energy, and time. In fact, the words Kung Fu or Gong Fu mean hard work in Chinese. Without further ado, let us welcome on stage our Kung Fu performer led by Amber Min, who have undoubtedly spent a lot of Kung Fu.
Next, we have dragon dance, or wulong, which is another form of traditional dance and performance in Chinese culture performed during Chinese New Year, just like blind dance. However, instead of being dressed up like a dragon, they are manipulating a humongous dragon using bamboo sticks.
It may not sound like much, but it really is difficult. If you want to do dragon dance, you better have beefy arms.
In this performance, you will see a dance team simulate the imagined movements of a fierce dragon in a sinuous and undulating manner.
Dragons, which in fact are one of the 12 Xingshao, or zodiac signs, are a symbol of Chinese culture, representing great power, dignity, wisdom, and benevolence. You know, I really wish I was born as a dragon, but instead I was born as a monkey.
No one really cares. But moving on, this dance, which originated around 200 BCE during the Han Dynasty, was originally supposed to be a rain dance performed during droughts. Over time, this dance became associated with good luck, or fu, bringing good fortune whenever it is performed. The longer the dragon is in the dance, the more luck it will bring to the community.
However, sadly this year, they were not able to have dragon dance because of COVID-19 restrictions. So instead, we'll be showcasing last year's dragon dance performance.
So without further ado, let us welcome the dragon and Huang Ying, our dragon dance members led by last year's senior, Jason Lee.
Now then, wasn't that impressive? Let's give another round of applause. Okay, now here comes the final performance of the night. And we hope that you will enjoy it. We saved the best by far for last. The fashion show. Everyone prepare for the exquisiteness of your fashion models. They are cooler than my mom's Liao Mian. They're fabulously out of style.
Like Qing Dynasty out of style. Tonight we will see students take it grandpa style and mock traditional Chinese clothing. Stuff that was hip from the days of the Manchus.
A great example is the qipao, a one-piece Chinese dress originating in the 17th century. My personal favorite is the changshan, or literally the long shirt, a traditional Chinese robe worn by men.
Anyways, endowed in breathtaking elegance and breathtaking beauty, ladies and gentlemen, please give it up for the act leaders Eric Yi, Andrew Fan, and their models, giving us a mouth-watering, once-in-a-lifetime fashion show.
Woo!
And that wraps up tonight's show. Thank you for sticking to the end.
It did not cost anything this year because our show is virtual and we wanted to...
Given the uncertainty brought by the pandemic, this year's China Night represents a year of tremendous work as a club and community to make this all possible. While this certainly wasn't how I imagined my last China Night, I'm grateful, and my fellow club members are as well, for this opportunity to celebrate our cultural heritage. Chinese Club and China Night have been some of the most meaningful parts of my high school journey, and I've been able to grow in unforeseen ways as a result. It's been an honor having the privilege to spearhead this amazing event, and I'm sure all my fellow council members share the same sentiment. Thank you to each and every one of you for making this all possible.
Two more people. We wanted to encourage anyone to donate the $15 that would usually go towards the show to an organization of your choice. A few nonprofit organizations we'd like to mention include Asian Americans Advancing Justice, a civil rights organization advocating for AAPI Americans, and Stop AAPI Hate, a coalition of organizations.
It's definitely been a challenge this past year, hosting such a large event virtually, and having to communicate between both North and South during this pandemic added upon the complexity. But after hours upon hours of careful planning, rehearsals, meetings, and recordings, we somehow made this event possible. I could never be more proud of everything our students have accomplished tonight.
We'd now like to take the time to thank several people because this event would not be possible without their continued support.
We also support the various Asian-owned businesses in our local community. For example, ordering takeout at any of the Asian restaurants nearby is a great way to give back and get something delicious to eat too, because it is always a good excuse to spend money on yummy food.
We'd also like to thank our North Council members, Seth Young and Caitlin Chung, for being our wonderful president and vice president, and for overseeing our work behind this event. We'd like to thank Grace and Lou for volunteering in so many odd jobs and tasks, and truly being there to help with anything and everything. We'd like to thank Ashley Tui for serving as our secretary, Oliver Zhang for serving as our treasurer, and Jimmy Jen for serving as our historian. We are also grateful for your hard work, and thank you for the great experiences of working alongside you all.
We'd like to thank our extraordinary club members who made this event come to life, and for our ACT leaders in giving them guidance towards putting on such an amazing show. Thank you as well to our booth members and leaders who were talented enough to accommodate this year's virtual booth format and made our event spectacular.
We'd like to thank our Chinese teachers for being fantastic advisors, and our staff for offering all of their ideas to make this event truly special. We'd also like to sincerely thank our school administrators and VIP guests for supporting China Night, as well as allowing us to host and promote our event. At this time, we'd like to include a few words from some of our VIP guests.
Hi, this is West Windsor Council President Andrea Mandel. Thank you for holding China Night, and I look forward to seeing everybody in person next year. Have a great evening.
For many years as a council member and as a former WWP school board member, I gladly attended China Night. I really enjoyed being part of the celebration of Chinese culture. The food was delicious, the cultural activities were fun, and the performances were always quite amazing. China Night brought people together in order to gain a better understanding of Chinese culture. My thanks to all the teachers and students who have worked so hard in putting together a fantastic community event. Congratulations and good luck to the graduates of the class of 2021.
This message is delivered on behalf of Deputy Mayor Neil Lewis of Plainsboro Township. Congratulations to the Chinese clubs and all the participants of this very special, if delayed, China Night. Please accept best wishes on behalf of all my colleagues on the Plainsboro Township Committee on bringing us a step closer to normalcy during an exceptionally challenging year for us all. Very best wishes to all in our Chinese American community and continuing good wishes during this new year with a message for happiness, health, and prosperity. As we move forward, we salute our community diversity as a strength and anticipate sharing more meaningful events with our friends and neighbors in Plainsboro and West Windsor. With best regards, Neil J. Lewis.
Thank you, VIPs, for the kind words. And last, but certainly not least, we'd like to thank you audience members for coming out to this event. Your attendance and participation here tonight makes all our hard work worthwhile. You all are the reason why we have hosted China Night and will continue to do so in the years to come. And now, we'd like to inform you of a few things. Firstly, for those of you who may not know, May is Asian American Pacific Islander Month, or AAPI Month. And what a great way to end this month with China Night. AAPI Month began as a bill in Congress in the late 1970s and officially became a designated heritage month in 1992. May was originally chosen for the month to recognize the arrival of the first Japanese immigrants to the U.S. in May of 1843 and the completion of the Transcontinental Railroad by Asian immigrant workers in May of 1869. The overarching goal of AAPI Month is to recognize AAPI American history, celebrate our rich cultural heritage, and amplify the often overlooked experiences of AAPI Americans.
Secondly, as you have realized, the show did not cost anything this year because our show is virtual and we wanted to make it accessible to more people. We wanted to encourage anyone to donate the $15 that would usually go towards the show to an organization of your choice. A few nonprofit organizations we'd like to mention include Asian Americans Advancing Justice, a civil rights organization advocating for AAPI Americans, and Stop AAPI Hate, a coalition of organizations that collects data on anti-Asian Pacific Islander hate crimes. Alternatively, you could also support the various Asian-owned businesses in our local community. For example, ordering takeout at any of the Asian restaurants nearby is a great way to give back and get something delicious to eat too, because it is always a good excuse to spend money on yummy food.
In recognizing AAPI Month, our district has been holding Pan-Asian American History Month. Our take on the event should be more inclusive of the almost 50 countries in Asia, all of different cultures and traditions. These events in the high school level have included guest speakers, literature read-ins, weekly podcasts, movie nights, and so much more, and it has been truly wonderful to bring these experiences to our students within WWP. That being said, we'd like to briefly mention one more event that you all might be interested in. On June 16th from 12:30 to 1:30 p.m., Dr. Tim Yen will be hosting an after-school session to talk about how Asian American culture can influence our anxiety and decisions. Dr. Yen will be providing two sessions for WWP, one for students and one for parents, to better address their respective concerns. As the author of his newly released book, Choose Better, The Optimal Decision Framework, he will also be providing a highly relevant message to our students on how our decisions inform our most authentic selves. For more information, please visit our website and follow us on Instagram at www.paahmonth. We hope to see you there!
Thank you for sticking with us to the very end of the show, and we hope you have a great evening.